rock history lesson. Number two, Paul Revere, the great American patriot, riding through the streets of Boston screaming, "The British are coming! The British are coming!" But think for a moment, if it wasn't Paul Revere on top of that horse, what if it was this goof? What if it was John Cena riding through the streets of Boston? Well, first of all, they would have shot you on sight just based off this stupid-ass outfit alone. If John Cena had led the American Revolution, right now all of us would be playing cricket, we'd be sipping tea, and we'd be blessing the Queen. You see, John, they'd be sick of you then, just like we're sick of you now. The people back then, they'd be crying into their Johnny cakes, pleading for someone to come along and shut your mouth. Then bam, prayers answered. The Rock shows up. The Rock would actually invent a time travel machine to travel back into 1776 just to whoop John Cena's ass. The time machine would land. The Rock's music would hit. If you smell, The Rock's doors would open. The flux capacitor still smoking. The Rock steps out. People silenced. Jaws dropped. Never seen anything like The Rock. 25% black, 25% Samoan, and 50% Clydesdale. The Rock, sorry, brown beauty. The Rock has got you beat. Easy, big fella. Easy. Benjamin Franklin would have looked at The Rock and looked up and said, screw that damn kite. That man invented electricity. Then every woman in Boston would be lining those cobblestone streets, ready to give The Rock a piece of that sweet Boston cream pie. The people back then, John, they'd be so happy, so elated, because The Rock would have whooped your ass. They'd be showering The Rock with gifts. A gift like this, they'd be singing songs onto The Rock, sounding something like this. Johnny Cena went to town riding on a pony. Rock stuck a feather up his ass and called him a jabroni. John, they'd be so happy then that The Rock would have whooped your ass in, just like The Rock is gonna whoop your ass at WrestleMania. And if the great American patriot, Paul Revere, would be alive today, he'd be riding through the streets of Boston, screaming with joy, The Rock is coming, The Rock is coming, coming to WrestleMania, John, to whoop your punk ass. But before that, The Rock is coming to the TD Garden to get in your face tonight.
Just like you. I'll have to call you back. John Cena. You got a lot of nerve coming to The Rock's house. But you finally came here. Face to face. You want to say something to The Rock? Man to man? Is that what you want to do? Well, here's your chance. Here's your final chance to talk like a man.
You can't see me. You can't see me.
John Cena, don't even think about it.
Yo.
No, don't do yo.
Okay.
No, no gang signs. Don't do that. No, don't even think about rapping. John Cena, no, you're not gangsta. You're not from the hood. No, you want to talk to me, you talk to me like an adult. I'm through with that. Talk to me like an adult.
Yo, my name is John Cena. I'm putting on the hurt. I'm a big, tough guy with a bright purple shirt. You want some? Come get some.
Okay. All right, John Cena, we should have had this talk long ago. It's time for you to have a talk with the People's Champion. John, I know that when I left 7 years ago, you took the ball and you ran with it, right? But you didn't run that far. It's okay, but you were trying and you were running. Your little legs were running and running for years. You became the man in the WWE. And think about this. Not only did you try, John, but you succeeded. Think of the cultural impact you've had on the world. Look at it like this. Kermit the Frog, Barney the Dinosaur,
bingo!
And now you. And not only that, think about the demographic that you've dominated. John Cena, you own the 2 to 5 year olds. Yeah, they love you. But the truth is, and this is gonna be difficult, do you know why you'll never be as good as The Rock? Tell me.
Because I'm not that talented?
Yes, John Cena, because you're not that talented. It took such a big man to admit what you just did. Finally, the big elephant in the room. Go, he's gone. Yeah, go, bye-bye, bye-bye, elephant. Look at the elephant go, bye-bye. So John, now that we've gotten that out of the way, you've released all that off your shoulders. Gosh, that's a heck of a load for you to carry around all these years. How does it make you feel? It doesn't matter how it makes you feel! Oh no. No, John Cena, are you crying? Oh, John, you can't be crying. John Cena shouldn't be crying. The Rock and all the millions and millions, we've seen your awful movies. You don't see us crying. Oh, John. Oh no, look, I don't have any toilet paper. But I have the next best thing to toilet paper. Here, go ahead and blow your nose. Nobody cares about this anyway. That's all, blow your nose again. Good, nobody cares about this shirt anyway. Come here, buddy. Listen, I know it's very hard to admit what you just admitted, but I gotta tell you, I'm proud of you. We're all proud of you, because you're not that talented, but you admitted it anyway. Turn that frown upside down. Let me see a little smile. A little bit? All right. I'll tell you what, I got a gift for you. I got something for you that you're gonna love. Abracadabra, yabba dabba!
Hustle, loyalty, respect, and fruity pebbles. Yes!
Yeah, I know! This is your favorite, I know! Hustle, loyalty, respect, all that hot garbage that you say, it doesn't matter, because here, look, oh! There's your hero, Fred Flintstone! That's your guy right there, look! Fruity Pebbles, vitamin D, big for your muscles, right there's a dream. You'll never have muscles like The Rock, but you could try one day. That's what heaven looks like. Look, a big bowl of Fruity Pebbles. Who's the man? Yeah, who's the people's champ? Yeah, who's always gonna own John Cena? Yeah, give me some again. All right, you take these with your no-talented behind and you go enjoy the Fruity Pebbles.
Can I eat them now?
You can eat them right now, you untalented little Fruit Loop. Enjoy them.